Hello and welcome to the Develop Forum 2021. I'm Teresa and together with my colleague Dennis, I want to show you in the next 30 minutes how efficient sales management with Develop and Salesforce works.
Hello, I'm Dennis. Welcome from my side as well.
So what is today's agenda? First of all, I want to talk about the challenges in sales management. Afterwards, I will show you our solution approach, a document management integrated in Salesforce. Afterwards, I will go to the benefits and tell you what's the impact on your business. And at the end, Dennis will show you in the live system a typical sales use case with Develop and Salesforce. Before I start, I wanted to throw in a motivation quote from Tony Hsieh. Tony Hsieh is the CEO of Zappos, which is a quite successful company. And he once said, customer service shouldn't be a department, it should be the entire company. So what does it mean? The customer should always come first. All efforts are always geared towards our customers. So you should always think about the best customer support you can give them. So how does customer support start? It starts with documents and information and with data. But what is the current situation in the companies right now? So probably also in your company, there are a lot of systems in use, like a file server, ERP system, CRM, like Salesforce, Microsoft 365, and so on. And in all those systems are a lot of information and documents stored. And even daily new documents are generated. And so information of the customer are spread all over the company. And what's the problem now? When we talk to our customers, they usually tell us, well, we have different user groups within our company. So we have the sales manager who work with Salesforce. And we have the accounting department, which works with the ERP system. But ERP licenses and Salesforce licenses are quite expensive. So not everybody has an ERP license or a Salesforce license. And what's the problem here? Well, as you can see, you don't have access to all the information and documents of the systems. And what's happening then? What's the problem? Well, the accounting department now asks the sales manager, can you please give me the document XYZ of this customer? And what is he doing? Of course, he's downloading it and sending a copy via email. And this could be also vice versa. So the sales manager could also ask the accounting department and so on. So it takes a lot of time to find all the information. What else is the problem here? Every time you're downloading a copy, you're creating a duplicate. So you don't even know what is the valid version, which changes are made by my colleagues, where is it stored, where can I find it? And also it takes a lot of time to get everything together. So that's kind of frustrating for the sales manager. When you have like a customer inquiry, it takes you maybe longer to find the information than actually, yeah, doing the reorder or something like that. So it's just frustrating for the sales manager, and this is where we can help. We collect all the information from all system and store them in our developed documents, the document management system. And then we can provide access for all employees in the company, even though they don't have a Salesforce license or ERP license. How exactly does this work? Well, we collect documents from all systems and store them centrally in the DMS. For example, from the file storage, office, email, paper documents, business applications like SAP or Dynamics 365, or of course, Salesforce. So we collect them, store them in the document management system, and make them available for all employees in the whole company. So this is kind of great customer support. And the best thing about it, we structure them in folders. So you as a sales manager, you work with customer information. So you need all the information belonging to a customer at a glance. So we have the customer account folder, and below that we have a opportunity folder with like all the document types, the purchase order, order confirmation, invoice, and so on. So we structure them just the way you need it. We have folders, subfolders, and different document types. And this gives you the perfect 360-degree view on your customers. You don't have to search for information. You just have all the documents you need in one place. So we are combining two strong systems. On the one hand, you have the CRM system, Salesforce, and on the other hand, you have developed documents as a strong document management system. And together, those with the combination of both systems, we are making your sales processes more efficient and much faster. So what impact does this have on your business and what are the benefits? Well, it's quite obvious. As I already mentioned before, you have the perfect 360-degree view on your documents. You have a global central document management system where all the documents you need are stored. The customer inquiries, you can work them faster, so you can answer your customer inquiries. You can answer your customer much faster. You can just be there for your customer and spend the time instead of searching for your customer. With the native integration in Salesforce, you don't have to get used to a new system. So Salesforce is your daily business application. And we integrate right into Salesforce. You don't have to get a new environment and you don't have to learn anything new. The next thing is you save time and money. Of course, time, you don't have to search for documents. You don't have to ask your colleagues and you don't have to check if this is the valid version or not. And your IT department probably knows storage costs in Salesforce are quite expensive. So you can get rid of this expensive storage cost and just use developed documents as a much more cheaper storage system. The next thing is make usage of the DMS functionalities. You can start workflows right in the system. You can use the full text search to even find documents much faster. And you can just avoid the duplication of documents, the duplicate work. And yeah, you can also integrate the digital signature develop sign. Enough of the theory. Now I want to hand over to Dennis. He is showing you now a typical use case in Salesforce.
So thank you very much, Teresa. Oh, yes. A short introduction of myself. As I've said earlier, I'm Dennis Rees, and I'm currently the product owner of Develop Connect for Salesforce CRM. So to illustrate you the presentation with a concrete process, let's imagine a reordering process from an existing customer. So the sales manager in charge receives a call from an existing customer and they want to order, of course, 10 more licenses of Develop Connect or Develop Documents for Salesforce CRM. So at first, the sales manager has identify the existing customer, of course. He wants to get an overview of the customer, which means he wants to see what opportunities were created, what documents were stored, what are the latest quotes, etc. And of course, he wants to know, okay, what were the prices we were giving the customer? What were the percentages, the discounts, etc. So afterwards, the sales manager probably will create a new opportunity in Salesforce, which could be the process you having in your company right now. And then afterwards, the inside sales department will probably create a new quote for these 10 new licenses. And in our scenario, we are thinking there could be an ERP system in the background that will create this new quote. And then the last thing to do is the sales manager has to send the quote to the customer. This should be the process for today. And for this, let's have a look at the system. So as you can see, we're starting our presentation in the sales dashboard of our Salesforce demo environment. You know that Salesforce offers different cloud platforms as well for the service department, for the customer department. This is a sales process. So we're having a look at the sales cloud. On the right-hand side, you can see our standalone web client, Develop Cloud. But this is a topic for our next video. So in our case, we created a new account record for the company Develop Forum Company Limited. And this is a basic page layout. On the right-hand side, you can see the activity stream. And in our scenario, what we were thinking about or what we were talking about, the sales manager received a call. And yeah, we are going to use the Salesforce basic functionality to log this call. So you can see right now the comment is added in our video. And then it's added, it's logged into the activity stream. So every sales manager knows what happened with, what were the latest activities with this customer. In the central regions of the page layout, there is a normal metadata part. So we have a lot of information right here. And this is a typical thing, except you can see it. The third register is labeled developed documents. And when I click on it, behind it lies our new component that comes with Develop Connect for Salesforce CRM. So in this screen, you can see that the Develop Document list was loaded. And this is a component made of native Salesforce components. So every user should know intuitively how to use it. In this list, in this table, every document is displayed that is connected to the develop from Company Limited, but it is stored in the DMS system behind it. So, and then as you can see, we have different columns like the type, and the second column is the most important one or the most interesting one here, because with our DMS functionality comes, like Teresa told you, we have the possibility to categorize these documents. So you can see here in the stream, on the screen, that we have different types like customer agreement here, etc. And of course the quote the sales manager is looking for. And with our native filtering and sorting mechanisms, the sales manager who wants to find the latest quote that was made can easily filter. And just seeing here on the screen, yes, there is one older quote. And with an easy click, he could show it to him. But first, we want to show you different approaches here. So we close the filter section, and the sales manager could also use our full text search, which means that with typing in Develop Connect, we are not only searching for metadata, we are searching for the content of the file itself. So in this case, Develop Connect was found in a lot of documents. So we close this one, this approach as well. So back to the original idea, clicking, filtering on the quote section. And here you go. Here you have your quotation you were looking for. In this particular case, there could be another approach, more the Salesforce basic approach. And this means we want to have a real look on the opportunity record in Salesforce. So for this reason, we could go to the related tab and change to the opportunity. But we could also use our digital folders here that you're seeing. And there's also a digital folder for opportunities. This could be a start. But in this case, we are going right to the related tab. You can see on the related opportunities that there's one entry. And this is the first opportunity. This is exactly what we are looking for. So with a click, we open the record. And so this is, once again, the basic page layout of an opportunity. Could look like yours in your company as well. And once again, the third register tab is our develop documents. So with a click on it, we see the develop document list pops up again. And in this case, there are only four entries and not the bunch more we've seen on the account, because we are searching here for every document in DMS that is connected this time to the opportunity record itself. And we see here three entries, three documents You can see that on the icon on the left-hand side of the table. And one digital folder. Once again, we create digital folders for everything that happens with or for every document that is stored to this opportunity. And the last document here is the quote we were looking for. With a click on it, a modal dialog opens. And here we can see our developed documents document viewer. And this document viewer is far more powerful than the Salesforce default viewer. So you can see on the left-hand side, we have a small page layout, page preview functionality, where we can see the content of the next documents. In the middle section, you could see it. It's just the zooming function, but Salesforce doesn't offer it. Way more interesting is here the full text search functionality. This time, we are looking for the content of the file for the highlighted word here in the document itself, not the whole bunch of documents that we've seen previously. So we are looking for Salesforce because we want to find the position where Develop Connect for Salesforce was sold last time. Yeah, there are a whole bunch of more functionality in this document viewer. You can see it on the top. We have a register for properties. This contains the metadata. We also offer general notes that you can apply or attach to the document. Of course, we have a versioning system, as Teresa told you. Again, a versioning duplicates. This is a pretty strong feature here. And we have, on the right-hand side, more functionality that comes with Develop Cloud and some additional features like the digital signature. In this case, back to the scenario, we want to find out what did we sold, how many times did we sell it, at what cost, and we can see down there, there was a special discount of 5%. Okay, so we close the window, we can see we are back where we started the thing from. We are back at the opportunity, we're going back to the account, we found our information, so the next thing is basic Salesforce sales process here. The sales manager will create a new opportunity for selling the 10 more licenses. So I've prepared it, you can see it there in the opportunity name. I'll choose a random date, end of October here, and we have to choose a stage. Interesting is just the part with the probability. This is an existing customer. He asked for 10 more licenses. The probability is pretty high that we will win this opportunity. And then we're back at the account page layout. We can switch to the related tab and we see the new opportunity there. We switch right into it. New opportunity. We switch to our developed documents section here, and this time the developed documents list is empty. Of course, this is a new record, so we didn't upload anything there, and there was nothing happened in the background that created files. So of course it's empty. Now, it could be a good idea that the inside sales department knows, okay, I want a new quote for 10 more licenses. So for this, I'm using the Salesforce standard functionality of Salesforce tasks. And there I can assign this inside sales department. In this example, I'm just assigning myself, but with assigning it to the inside sales department, they will be notified and they know, okay, I've got to create a quote for this specific opportunity. And then, as I've stated earlier, there could be an ERP system in the background that will create this new quote. There could be a different process in your company. There could be someone manually creating this quote. It doesn't matter. If they upload it to the document management software, not in Salesforce, to the document management software that lies beneath every primary application, it will be shown here. And when the task is closed, you as a sales manager will be notified, okay, the quote is created, and here I've just clicked the refresh button, and there it is. There's a new opportunity digital folder, and of course the quote. So the sales manager from now on has to only check, okay, is everything okay? He could also attach redlining functionality annotations on the document itself if something is wrong and send it back to be corrected. But in this case, I think we focus back on the process. So we found our information. We've created a new opportunity. The quote was created. And the last thing we need to do is sending the quote to our customer. And on every result that our component gives, we have a context menu. In this case, it was the send file by mail context menu. And there on the right upper side, we have access to all Salesforce standard email templates. So in this case, we want to send a quote. So we are choosing our quote template there. You can see the subject is populated. You can see that the body of the email is populated. And in there, you can see it's the marked thing was a placeholder. And the placeholder, of course, is replaced with the real data behind it. And this was the opportunity name in this case. After the kind regards section, there was also a placeholder for the current logged in user. This was me. And so all I need to do is enter recipient, edit, and press the send email button. And then the thing here is now, this is our component, but we're using basic Salesforce technology because they're good at it. And so in the background, there was a job created for the Salesforce environment to send this email via standard functionality. So with this idea behind it, the powerful CRM system can use all their cool features like the bell notification, so the user is notified that the email is really sent to the customer just a few seconds ago. And also you can see right on the right hand side that the activity stream was once again populated with this new email function that you're seeing here. And because this email is connected to the new opportunity, which is connected to the account record. When we switch back to that account, we can see the email on the right-hand side also in the activity stream. So everybody who is looking at this Salesforce functionality and wants information, he can see it right here. You can see in the document list for the account, there is a new quote. You can also see that in the list is the new digital folder for this opportunity. And when I click on this, our document viewer opens once again and we can see the quote in the digital folder. But it was connected to the opportunity and not the account record. But we are summarizing everything that is connected to the account. And I think you've seen a sales process, how it could be in your company. Of course, there are differences in the process itself and difference in the Salesforce environment of your company. But this could be a process. And we just wanted to show how powerful the connection of both systems are. So I think this should be it for the live demonstration. And I will get back to Teresa. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Dennis. I think your presentation made once again clear which gap develop closes at the develop Salesforce environment. So here, once again, you see the full text search, you see the metadata and the classification of documents. Those options you just have with develop documents. And this was only one use case we just shown you. You probably have some more sales use cases. If you have questions or if you want to talk about a different use case, feel free to contact us. And if you're thinking now, okay, I want to optimize my sales processes, then you can just go to the Salesforce App Exchange and download it there or go to our develop store. It's available within a few minutes, but of course, we are also there to help you with any questions and with the implementation or with any use cases you have in mind. Thank you for listening and enjoy the rest of the develop forum. Goodbye.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.